Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is the long-awaited, long-promised video about makeup and how to do makeup for gray hair. While I do love gray hair, I do realize also that it washes me out. So ever since going gray, I started using a lot more targeted makeup that really accentuates my features and prevents me from looking washed out, because gray hair can make you look a little bit washed out. Of course, I do want to mention that nothing replaces good skin. So in the last 6 months or so, I have focused on my skincare. I have completely revamped my skincare routine and I have seen dramatic differences. If you are interested in watching my skincare routine, I'll link it down below and I'll have it pop up right here for you to enjoy. All of my skincare products are either cruelty-free or vegan or both, and I do try to get as low waste product as possible on the market. So that's something that's really important to me, and that's what this channel is also about. So if you're into that, watch that video. At the same time as kind of revamping my skincare routine and starting this channel, I also started to focus more on really targeting cruelty-free makeup brands. However, since we have to wear masks right now, my makeup usage has gone down a lot. So I have been really slow at using up the makeup that I had before this journey. I really want to repeat myself again here and say that using up what you have first, even though it may not be the best quality or may not be cruelty-free in terms of makeup, is really the most sustainable option before buying new sustainable cruelty-free makeup. So a lot of the things that you'll see today in the video are very not sustainable, not from cruelty-free brands, but they are pieces of makeup that I've had before and I'm using them up before getting sustainable brands. So I'm not a really huge makeup fan in my daily life. I never usually go beyond sunscreen, some brow color, some mascara, and some concealer. But for the purposes of this video, I have put on a full face of makeup. And actually, I don't even have my BB cream on. I just have sunscreen and a little bit of concealer on and some blush. But other than that, I don't have like a cake of makeup on. The other thing I want to mention is that, you know, makeup is an individual choice. My coloring is very pale with cool undertones, and I have hazel eyes and obviously gray hair, which is actually getting a little bit brown in places, which is kind of strange. So what I'm trying to say is the makeup colors that you choose will highly depend not just on the fact that you have gray hair, but also on your whole coloring. So don't take everything that I say here as like truth. I'm also not a makeup artist, so I'm not a professional. If that's what you're looking for, this is not a place for you. These are just some choices that I have made for myself, and if they work for you. So now that we have to wear a mask all the time, I find that an extra pop of color around the eye area really does make a difference, with additionally some concealer around the eyes. I am currently looking for a new concealer because I have been using up my old concealer. So if you have really good cruelty-free concealer choices, do link them down below or tell me what the brand name is and I will check them out, because this is what I currently need. So because I'm usually in a mask most of the day, I try to do my eyes in the morning. I currently am using up my old Chanel palette. Obviously it's not sustainable, but I have it. And like I said before, it's really important to use up what you have first before buying the most sustainable option on the market that is affordable for you. So what I try to do is put a little bit of shimmer on my eyes as a base, cool tone shimmer, and then some cool tone brown in, you know, like the corners of my eyes to bring some drama. So like I said, I have the Chanel palette, but I am looking really closely at the Elite palette or the Couleur Caramel palette. Both brands are vegan and cruelty-free and really, really sustainable. It's just one is made in France and one is Canadian brand. So France is closer to me now, but if I ever go to Canada to visit, I will definitely look into getting Elite. In terms of mascara, I have tried quite a few cruelty-free brands, and the one that is by far my favorite is again Couleur Caramel. I like them because they are all natural. They come in really sustainable packaging that's made from recycled materials, And they are vegan and they're good quality products. So my favorite currently is the Backstage Mascara as well as the Lengthening Mascara. I find them really just easy to use. They go on really well and they wash off with just water, which I also love. For my brows, I'm currently using an old eyeshadow that is just matte, but I am looking for a brown liner color. I don't even know anything about brows, so if you have any ideas, again, tell me in the comments and I will check them out because I'm looking for that, you know, bushy brow look with some color because my brows do need quite a bit of filling in. They are just getting kind of pale for some reason. So in pre-mask times, as you know, I'm a huge fan usually of lipstick, bright lipstick, but since I work in a very crowded environment, I have to wear a mask all the time, so my lipstick usage has gone down dramatically. So I still have so many lipsticks that I bought before this journey that I'm on, the sustainability journey, and I'm still using them up, unfortunately. But I do have some things that I have tried and some things on my wish list that I want to share with you. So in terms of color, again, to remind you, I'm quite pale with cooler tones, so I find that bright lipstick that is red, but it has like the cooler undertones in it, really looks good on me. And I have a few versions of that lipstick color. I also find that purple-ish tone lipsticks look good and they go well with my coloring. I don't enjoy the warm colored lipstick on my face, if they're bright or not bright. It's just the warmth brings out like the yellow tones from my skin, but also the yellow tones from my hair, which I do not enjoy. I'm still really torn about the nude color lipstick. Sometimes I really like it and sometimes I don't. I think it depends really on my mood. What do you think? What do you think of this particular nude lipstick? Tell me, because I can't decide. Sometimes when I want a more nude look, I will put this nude lipstick on top of my pink, like a pale pink lipstick, and it seems to do the trick for me. But sometimes, especially when the weather is gray like it is today, the nude just like doesn't work. So I really want to know what you think about this look. I also found that matte lipstick does not work for gray hair. It somehow washes the whole face out. So I do enjoy a creamier lipstick a lot more than a matte nude lipstick. And even though I was a huge fan of matte lipstick before, right now it just does not work for me at all. So let me know what you think once again. Some of the brands of lipsticks that I like are Carrie Weiss, which come in these like super cool stainless steel packages. And it's a Danish brand. I also love Color Caramel, which is a French brand, and they come in recycled packaging, like paper packaging. And I love Elate as well, which are really beautiful, but I don't own one. I've only tried it for my friend. The other one I really want to try is Axiology, and that's the lip crayons, and they come in completely like compostable packaging, so I'm really excited to try those out, but I haven't had the chance yet. In the end, I find makeup is an individual choice, gray hair or not. It just, for me, I find because of my coloring and because of the look that I'm going for, the cooler tones work better for me in clothing actually and in makeup. So depending on what your coloring is, you make your own choices. However, I do find that skin is the basis for everything. If you have good skin, you don't need to have a lot of makeup. I also find that for gray hair, all it takes is a little bit of concealer and a little bit of a brighter lip, and then you're good to go. So sometimes when I'm just puttering around the house or I have to go grocery shopping, all I do is I put on concealer and a little bit of a bright lip and not even brow filler or mascara, and I feel good about the way I look and I feel way less washed out. And that's all I need. And it's all thanks to the skin that I have now because I've been working on it for so long. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you'll be back next time. Next time I'm hoping to put together a little bit of a lookbook for my fall outfits that are gonna be completely secondhand or made from sustainable brands. So I hope you come back for that and I'll see you again next time. Bye.